All right, here we are. This is Thursday. Wow, not a good Thursday. Usually Thursdays are my best days. This is going to be a Red Day recap. On this Thursday, September 7, 2023, well, I only had, well, first of all, I have some trades that I'm carrying overnight. We'll talk about that in a minute. But I had one indice trade today, and that was on the Mini Dow. Not a big fan of the Mini Dow. Wish I wouldn't have traded it, but I did, and just got whipsawed. I came in with a short. I had a sell on the Mini Dow. Came in early. It came in around 8:15, I think it was, this morning. Pretty early, somewhere in there. And shortly after the opening, I did have a lower target down here, and never got close to it. I ended up getting stopped out, and I ended up buying. I had an HF2 buy right after the opening, and then it started falling back down, and it hit my stop. So not only did I take a loss on the short, but I also took a loss on the buy, and that was it for me, okay? When I'm trading the indices, don't like to take more than two losses in a row. If it's going to be go sideways, then I don't want to be a part of it. A lot of times you get whipsawed like that. There's not a lot of strength, and there's no really strong commitment, so there's no reason to continue to trade. So usually if I'm not going to hit it on the first trade, a lot of times I can catch the reversal, but if I lose on the reversal as well, it's probably not a market I want to be a part of. So I did take a loss on the Mini Dow. Let's look at stocks. I only traded a couple stocks here, so let's look at those. All right, so you know I've been watching Yang, you know, JDST. I didn't do any JDST today, but I did do some YANG. Now, YANG, very similar to JDST. It's slow mover, a lot of float. So I am actually carrying this overnight. So I did buy prior to the opening. It was a pairing pattern buy. Yes, it hit a few targets, but I really wasn't concerned about these targets. I'm really going for a bigger run here. And you can see, came up, almost hit that upper target, but once again, I do see much higher targets, so I'm holding on the Yang overnight, and we'll just have to wait and see what it does tomorrow. I may even go through the weekend on Yang, all right? So, holding on the Yang, the next trade I took was WHLR. A lot of interest in WHLR, but let's just take a look at that. All right, WHLR also didn't do very good. Did have a buy up here. I believe this was a pairing pattern buy on this entry. Came in shortly after the opening. I really thought we were going to have a nice little run. I did have much higher targets. Unfortunately, it fell fairly quickly. Now, once it broke this $9 mark, I decided to go ahead and get out. And that's exactly what I did. Minimize my losses. I'm glad I did. I still ended up taking a nice little loss on that WHLR, but it could have been a lot worse. So, once again, just watching that market action, I mean, I was really disappointed to see that it wasn't going to continue its upward momentum. It started off really nice in the beginning of the day. Little pullback initially, but then shooting up. I really thought it was on my way to my target, but in this case, it just kind of just died out. And so I went ahead and got out, and like I said, once again, I'm glad I did, and I didn't try to re-enter. And then the other one is, let's look at the next trade. And I only traded two stocks today. One I'm carrying over. I'm sorry, three stocks. One I'm carrying over. All right, so let's take a look at this, and then we'll look at those results. GDC. Remember, GDC was one I carried over for the last couple days. I really wanted to go to this much higher target up here at 420. Couldn't get there, so I decided to pull the plug here before the end of the day. Still made a little bit of profit, but certainly not enough to cover all my losses, so let's take a look. Yeah, Mini Dow, 1449, really got chopped up on the Mini Dow. GDC picked up a little bit, not as much as I would have liked, and of course, WHLR lost there, 446, so the net-net of the whole day is it was a red day. Really disappointed on the action this Thursday, because usually Thursdays tend to be one of my better days. see a lot of action. And I think it's really because a lot of people don't trade on Fridays. And so everything gets kind of squared away on Thursday. So you see a lot of volatility. But, man, I just didn't see it. I just couldn't get anything to really hold its momentum. I was watching some other stocks, but, man, just nothing was really moving. There was really no conviction on anything. So, anyway, it is what it is. Will I trade more? Absolutely. Hopefully, we'll get some early morning volatility, maybe pick up a couple. But if everything starts to die again right after the opening, I'm probably just going to call it a day. So, anyway, let's see what happens tomorrow. We'll go from there. All right. Y'all have a good day.